So now we get to the big result. What is the big result? The big result is the singular valley decomposition. And what is the singular valley decomposition? Well, given any matrix A that's m by n, you can find a unitary matrix U, a unitary matrix V, and a diagonal matrix sigma, such that A is equal to U times sigma times V Hermitian transpose. Now, why do I say diagonal? Well, it's a rectangular matrix, right? So it may or may not be, the diagonal really means the main diagonal. So how should we actually look at this? Well, matrix A is some rectangular matrix, and for now, let's just say that M is greater than or equal to N. Then you end up with a unitary matrix U. This is matrix A. This is U, which is M by M. And then you end up with a diagonal matrix. And let's show the entries in that matrix. Sigma 0, sigma 1, up to some number sigma R minus 1. And then afterwards you get zeros. And everything off the diagonal is 0. This is the main diagonal. And notice that this has to be m by n. And then finally, you have a matrix V, such that if you take its Hermitian transpose, if you take U times sigma times V, you get your matrix A back. Now, another way of thinking about this is that at some point, you can block this and say, oh, there's a block of zeros here, there's a block of zeros here, there's a block of zeros here, and there's a diagonal matrix sitting right here. Now, R, we're going to find out, is actually equal to the rank of the matrix. Remember, the rank of the matrix is the number of linearly independent columns that matrix A has. These values right here are all positive. Okay. So if matrix has rank R, then all of these values are positive, and these values are known as the singular values. Okay. And we're going to assume always that the singular values are ordered from largest to smallest. They're all positive. They're ordered from largest to smallest. And that's the singular valley decomposition. So what we're going to do is we're going to prove its existence, and then we're going to use it as a tool to gain insight into the action of matrix A.